Hey everybody, what's going on? Emo Tempest here, and I'm joined with top 16 finisher of the North Carolina Final Material Cup, Irvin Diaz, piloting probably the most interesting deck in the room. We have Water Ice Crystals, repping Young Ex-Emil and Lady Lilith. Irvin, talk to me about this deck, please, man.
So when the set came out, I was immediately drawn to Lady Lilith, as you see here. Steal a character for three crystals. My buddies Jim and everybody else were like, well, there's no way you're going to get three crystals that fast. You know, you'll never use it more than once. And it was kind of a challenge. I wanted to prove that, yeah, I could get as many crystals and still have plenty more. Because as I was talking to somebody earlier today, as the crystal mechanic just keeps developing, they keep giving us a little bit more, all these effects are going to become really big. So my original test with it was, I used to do something like kind of fun, but it didn't work, is I would Leviathan the six cost and then bring in the Lady Lilith. But the meta changed and I had to adjust to it. So the cards that are new from the set that really makes the deck shine, Young Rahal, Young Ex-Emil, Vinat, and Lady Lilith. Those cards were able to, Vinat itself just lets you generate a lot of crystals. I can't remember who was the other light guy that used to develop crystals.
I talked about him too, but he's like an FFBE guy nobody cares about.
And because of the fact that his effect did nothing, but now she has to be dealt with because she can search for any card in the deck, or your opponent doesn't deal with her and they trade, you're going to remove something from game. So there becomes double effects from it. Then Astos here actually is your board clear. And he can actually cause a lot of problems because he's got Brave. It's just three crystals. Once again, I don't think I've ever had a game where I didn't have like 6, 7, 8, 9 crystals.
Yep, our crystal, you got up to 7 and then stayed around that area.
Yeah, and then we were, and you just stay there. Even in the top 16 match, I did it in the wrong order, unfortunately. I stole a Warrior of Light and a Refia, and I should have done it the reverse order. I wasn't thinking. And did it wrong. Because if I steal the Refia and the Warrior of Light, then I have... But I stole it on the same turn. And I still had three crystals left over. Miwa is a really nice addition to this that I put in the deck. Because you can go... So you can really spam out really fast on a turn. Because you can go Young Ex-Emil, search for Miwa, ready him on your turn. The next turn, do it again. If you have enough crystals and enough in there, then you... where is she? Lena... Bringing this into play, and you're now at 5 forwards that your opponent has to deal with real quick.
And you recur all the crystals, right?
You recur all the crystals, yeah. And you've lost no crystals at all.
Let's go through these real quick for everybody. So, 2 Toto, 3 Lena, 3 Rahal. I'm seeing 2 Ex-Emil.
Talk to me about 2 Ex-Emil. So, you don't want to see him all the time. That's the crazy part, is there are, like, he dies to summons. And that's the real thing. So summons will just kill him straight up. He's a good to have, and he can apply pressure. But there's a lot of games where I'll be like, oh, he's not the character I really need. This is really cool to me. It's in this because you can throw this out early. You can then young X to go get the Lena and then bring these two out, and it's every crystal that you have is now 7K'ing. And that's on your opponent's turn.
That's why she's in here. Cool.
Yeah. So she's just an easier way for Glaciella effects, just because of the fact that I didn't want to discard a card from hand. Like you're still generating so many crystals that when you're at 7 crystals, her effect really
it's cheaper.
Just
cheaper. CP value.
Correct. Wow. You're saving your hand. I used to have different summon in here. We went with Famfrit, so what was happening is I wanted to cast a second Lady Lilith. A lot of the times, I couldn't get it off the field. So we went with Famfrit here. Also, Famfrit with Vinat is a double removal.
That's old school plays, bro.
Right, yeah. Yeah, listen, we know how we used to. Yeah, we used to do that. Leviathan 6, it's required in this meta. We're not going to lie on that. And then all your backups. So this is why... The backup line is actually why the deck functions the way it does, and that it's the best to play. You have 8. You can go higher. I mean, you could go do 17 backups, but this is 16 backup lineup. Every single one gets you a crystal. This makes you prone to discard. This bounces a character back to hand. And then these are draw effects, and then just regular effects. So these also effects come in really really neat and can be used. Like I had somebody trying to AK something, I was just like, oh, okay, well, on my turn, we'll just break this. We're gonna replace it. Other than that, that's the deck. I mean, it generates a lot. A lot of people forget about the secondary effect from Shantotto also, where you just dull the board.
Yeah.
And it's just a good time. Like I said, I wanted it kinda, just like any other deck, it becomes a challenge, and I want to show people like, hey, you can play something different. Just got to tech for the meta. You got to make sure that you have it. These two right here is how you stop. If anybody's ever wondering, well, how does he get past Chaos? Drop those two on your Chaos phone, and then watch the opponent just be able to do nothing. They can't get over, because what do you do then is you just sack this and you just leave this on the board and you go tap on the next turn, kill your entire board, pass.
And then start recovering from there. Right?
And they have to start recovering from there. The only deck that really threw me off is Mono Earth, and that's just the recursion. I can't get away. I kept trying to find a way around the recursion of Mono Earth, but there's, you know, you take your picks on what decks you're willing to lose.
And how many Mono Earths did you play this weekend?
Two. And I beat both of them.
Oh shit.
So yeah, the first player kind of made a mistake. The second one, just didn't know what to do. It kind of surprised me because it's like, okay, well, what am I? Like, I would play the Lady Lilith and target the Warrior of Light, but he had already tapped it to kill my Leo.
Right.
So now I've got his Warrior of Light. He has to do something about his own Warrior of Light being on the field now. So this is just, like I said, this is a fun deck that if you guys, somebody wants to try. Anybody can always shoot me a message on Discord at DragoonXIX or a message in Messenger, it doesn't matter. And I can tell you more of the nuances of the deck, but it's kind of simple once you start seeing the flow, and once you get the backup lineup going. It's, you know, when you get five forwards out and your opponent says there, and then you just play one and then you get Titus ability, it makes it 10 times easier, right?
Yeah.
And you're getting your value from just a crystal.
We got the limit breaks over here too.
Yeah. So limit breaks, two Leos, one little Leo. That's really only for obviously Sid Randall, if you ever see him. One Titus, one Kuja, one Luna Freya, one Surgis. And that's it. That's the whole deck, guys.
Just, I guess, last question for you is any changes that you took out or that you would like to make after this?
Yeah, so actually, when I played this, and so the original concept of this didn't have this in there.
We
removed her, and the reason was I was afraid that having an off CP would throw the deck off them. But it never came up.
Never came up.
Yeah, I always just was like, oh, well, I can just discard for this for the Devel. That's no biggie. Or for the Scholar. We never had an issue getting her in the break zone. And it flowed very nicely. If anybody tries it out, like, I hope it flows just as well as it did it for me, because you know, obviously, we made it day two, right?
Day two.
And you played against me, and there was never a moment where we weren't going back and forth.
Yeah, it was a slugfest.
Yeah,
I only got lucky because you got water CP. He only had Severo out as a backup, and then that was fortuitous for me. But
yeah, two water cards or water CP, and we finished that game right there. The other game that I lost was just to a double X star. I stole one X star, lost the second one. So the deck runs good. It's where I like it. I mean, it does have its flaws, just like anything else.
Okay. Well, and again, one more time, any more changes you would make going forward? Like,
Right now, no. I think this is actually perfect for the meta that we have right now.
Oh, okay. Good to know.
There's nothing that I would remove. Even Miwa was, she was a new addition just recently. Like, these two were added right before the tournament, and Miwa effect came in 10 times more necessary than I thought it would. Yeah, look at this, stops the Warrior of Light.
We're a big fan of the Miwa here.
She, you know, she, how many pings, like, I got Ferris pinged, and I was just like, all right, on the third one, just play it. We'll heal everything. So.
All right, man. Well, that's awesome. Thank you so much, Griffin. Congrats on the top 16 finish.
Hey, no problem. Thanks, everybody.
All the
I appreciate
info
it.
In the description for you guys, and obviously comment if you want to know more. Take care.